ready for a restorative.
Senator Risa Hontiveros filed a resolution in the Senate seeking an investigation on the government's decision to assign cabinet members to cities in the National Capital Region and neighboring provinces of Bulacan, Cavite, Laguna, and Rizal. The opposition senator dubbed it as toxic micromanagement and an overstepping to local affairs. She added, most IATF members have no background in managing local governments or responding to a pandemic. She also questioned why Secretary Harry Roque has been tasked to oversee Pasay City when he should be focusing on his job as the presidential spokesperson, the same way Health Secretary Francisco Duque is assigned to monitor Quezon City when he should be managing the government's overall COVID-19 response. Malacañang earlier defended these assignments, saying IATF members will only serve as so-called big brothers to local chief executives.
Mali po yung interpretasyon ni Senator Hontiveros. Wala pong intervention, wala pong paghihimasok ang ginagawa namin. Tinatanong lang po namin kung paano makakatulong ang pangnasyonal na gobyerno sa mga lokal na pamahalaan.
COVID-19 National Policy Chief Implementer Secretary Carlito Galvez defended this further, citing Cebu City as an example. President Duterte previously assigned Environment Secretary Roy Simatu to supervise Cebu's COVID-19 response after it has been placed again under the enhanced community quarantine due to the spike in the number of COVID-19 cases. Galvez asserts assigning cabinet members to LGUs will also make it easier for the national government to gather data necessary for policy-making decisions.
Dapat makita po natin kung nag-harmonize ang local government officials at saka po yung national government. Kahit na maganda po yung ating plano, pero hindi po nakikita ang implementasyon sa baba, wala po mangyayari po sa ating plano.
Aside from Senator Hontiveros, Liberal Party Senator Francis Pangilinan also took a swipe at the government strategy. He said he doesn't understand how this can help the LGUs and would only add to what he called an ineffective approach to the COVID-19 pandemic.
Alam niyo naman, malapit na election. Election is itong si Senator Pangilinan. Di ako nagtataka sa mga maanghang na salita niya. Pero if you go by the track record of his own party, in similar disasters, his own party had dismal performance.
National Security Advisor Hermogenes Esperon, the cabinet member assigned to Makati City, met with Mayor Abby Binay Tuesday. Mayor Binay admits they need help in contact tracing efforts.
We have 35 personnel for contact tracing. Unfortunately, kapag isa doon magkasakit, we will have to quarantine all those close contacts. Napipilayan mo kami sa CESU. So yun po yung isang hinihiling mo namin from the national if they can provide us with manpower.
Going by the records, napakaganda ng mga programs ng Makati, ng Mayor Abby and the two districts. Maaaring mayroon akong makuhang best practices dito and then I can also transfer them to IATF tapos dadali namin sa iba. Mayroon din siguro akong makikita na pwede akong mag-suggest ng solution na ginagawa din ng ibang towns.
Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.